Hello everyone, in this video we will do a simple sliding door. So let's start by adding the static content back. You don't have to do this if you already have a door asset. Now we need to create an actor blueprint class for the door. Let's name it sliding door. Double click to open the blueprint. What you need to do now is drag and drop the door into the blueprint we just made. Let me just get this here. So here we have our door. Now we need to add a collision box to detect the player. Let's keep the name. Make sure it's not a child of the door because we don't want it to move with the door. So let's resize the collision area so it's appropriate. That looks good enough. Now let's go to the event graph. Here is where we will create the logic. Right click on the box, add event, add on component begin overlap, which basically means trigger the action when the player overlaps with the box. We also need the opposite case to reverse the action, which is add on component end overlap. Drag from the execute pin and choose timeline. We will use a timeline to make the slide animation. Connect the end overlap with the reverse input of the timeline. Double click to open the timeline. I will use a vector to change the position of the door. Lock the X and Z axis because our movement will be in the Y axis. You can see the green arrow down there pointing toward the Y axis. So hold shift and left click to add a keyframe. Let's set this to 0, 0. Add another keyframe and set it to 1 and 150. You can change this anytime you want. Click these buttons to scale down the timeline. Right click on the keyframe and choose auto. Okay, now we need to set the new location of the door. So choose set relative location for the door. You will notice it has the door as its target. Connect the vector we just made in the timeline to set the new location. And this is pretty much it. Hit compile and let's go back to the game. Now all you need to do is drag and drop the door anywhere you want in the level. Hit play and test the door. And there you go. You can also change how far the door travels in the timeline and the vector we made. Other than that, thanks for watching.